All right. Good morning. You are at the Tuesday 6 a.m. workout. I am Coach Steph. So, three big announcements this morning. One, if you plan to work out on Friday, it is a costume workout. People really do wear costumes to the workout. Okay. So we're not like trying to haze you and like make you wear costumes. Like, I plan on wearing a costume on Friday. So just so you're aware, and it's just for fun. You don't have to. If you can wear a costume and bring a pumpkin, not that big, that one is 75 pounds, but somewhere between 10 and 20 pounds pumpkin, you will use it in part of the workout. And then lastly, if you have not already done so and you plan to participate in the combine, make sure you sign up. The deadline to sign up is next week, November 3rd. Okay. So next slide. Did anyone check Facebook? Does anybody know how many squats Joe did with the 75 pound pumpkin? Did I just say 75? I just gave it away, didn't I? I said how many, did anyone know how many 75? That's awesome. Whoever's watching the replay is like, she's clearly very tired. So he did 75 squats with the pumpkin, and you're welcome to try, but I don't think that's a thing. So, all right, we are gonna have a 5 minute warm up. The first 3 minutes, I will run through them with you. And then we're just going to jog outside for the last 2 minutes. So I'll put 5 minutes on the clock. We're going to start with some heel sweeps. Five. All right. So when you are ready, you can start with heel sweeps. Should feel good because our hamstrings are a little tight from yesterday's RDLs. All right. So solid minute of heel sweeps. Good. About 30 more seconds of heel sweeps. All right, give me two more heel sweeps, and then we're going to move into Spider-Man step-ups. We're on a tall plank. Bring one foot next to your hand and turn in towards your knee, and then switch. Really sit those hips down to get a full hamstring stretch to feel really good after yesterday. Good. About 30 more seconds of Spider-Man's. Keep moving with Spider-Man's. You got two more, one on each side. All right, we're gonna move into a side plank. So I have my shoulders, hips, knees, and toes all in line, and I keep my hips off the ground. We're just gonna hold for 30 seconds. Your option is arm up in the air or hand on hip, you pick. Good, about five more seconds. Two. One, and switch sides. Same thing, shoulders, hips, and knees all in line, and that bottom hip is off the ground. You need at least 6 inches. Good, you've got about 10 seconds left. And then from there, we'll go outside and run two laps. Three, two, one. All right, come on up. You've got two laps jogging outside. If you don't want to jog, you can go on the bike instead. All So at home, usually there's people who are on the Zoom. There isn't anyone today. So real quick, we are doing power cleans. So you can use a barbell if you have one, dumbbells, or a kettlebell, and I'll show all three. We're doing burpees with max effort. There's five of them. And by max effort, we mean as high as you can jump. And then in here, they have four sprints. From the flower bed all the way to the mailbox is one, and then from the mailbox back is two. So they're going to be gone for about 2 minutes. It'll take about 20 seconds to get there. Quick break to kind of catch their breath and then come back. So for that, you will do 2 minutes of hard cardio. Because again, they're sprinting. Okay. If you would like to do 20 seconds on, 10 seconds break, like easier, 20 seconds on, 10 break, and do that four times, that is pretty much what we're doing in here. Okay. I'm going to go check and see how they're doing on their jog, and then I'll explain what's coming up next. All right, so real quick format for this workout. Very similar to last Tuesday, it's just shorter. So barbell complex, 20 minute time cap, okay? Absolute honesty. The top, like the fastest people in the last class got this done in 10 minutes. Everyone was done within 12 minutes, okay? So there's gonna be leftover time. Be prepared for that, okay? 20 minute time cap on the slide, it says 4 to 5 rounds. No, you do 5 rounds because again, you have plenty of time to get it all done. So make sure you get all 5 rounds in. Your limiting weight will be clean. That's gonna be the hardest piece. If you don't wanna use a barbell, I'll also show you some options. We can use dumbbells or we can use a kettlebell as well, okay? So you're gonna run through, it's a 6, a 5, and a 4, okay? So there's 6 barbell power cleans. So a normal hang clean is what we've been doing most often, and the hang clean starts just above the knees. For a power clean, I want you to start lower. You start midway from your shins, bring it all the way up and catch, okay? I think personally, the power clean is easier because with a power clean, you can use your legs. The hang clean, it's got to come from your back and your hips. It's a little harder. From here, I can use my legs to kind of get some momentum going, okay? The mistake I've been seeing most recently when we do these power cleans is people start here, right where the bumper plates are, like on the floor or shin level. They bring it up to a hang clean, they pause, and then they come up. I want to see one fluid motion from the floor. Use your legs to come all the way up. Does that make sense? Okay, so one motion midway from the shins and come up in the clean. 6 times, 6 power cleans. Then you've got burpees and it says max effort. What we mean is you go down on the ground for a chest to ground push-up, but when you come back up, that jump is as high as you can get. Okay, again, there's only 5 rounds. You're only doing 5, so it's 25 burpees. Last week you did something like 55 or 60 burpees. Or do we even do burpees? I don't know, push-ups, but make sure when you do your burpee, when you come down, okay, chest to ground and then kick in and then jump high, okay? If on your burpee you feel your form is going, the big thing we see is the worm where people go down and they kind of like stick their stomach down and then they come up. What I'd rather see is just kick out. So just kick out, and in and jump. Does that make sense? So if that push-up, if your form, if you are not solid, flat like a board, skip the part where you go chest to ground. Just kick out, come in, and jump. 5 burpees, and then we go for a sprint. The sprint starts at this flower bed outside our front door, the first door. You run as fast as you can to the mailbox, then decelerate. So run through the mailbox, decelerate, turn around, and then go from the mailbox, run through the flower bed, and then decelerate. Okay, it's about 40 yards. Okay, it's just 4 sprints. So again, last week you did something like 55 sprints. Today you're doing 20, so it's less than half of that. Okay, it's a 20-minute time limit. If you finish early, you can do some run walk intervals, just going back and forth to the mailboxes, or some farmer's carries, which means just take 2 heavy kettlebells and walk back and forth. But know that we have single arm farmer's carries coming up tomorrow. So kind of keep that in mind, okay? If you choose not to use a barbell, or for people at home who don't have a barbell, same movement for that power clean, just grab 2 dumbbells. And again, starting low, catch up on your shoulders. Starting low, catch up on the shoulders. Or if you don't have 2 dumbbells, same thing with a kettlebell. Start low and catch up high, okay? So, done my explaining. If you would like to grab whatever weights, again, whatever weight you can use for that power clean. Keep in mind, last week was max out week, so a lot of people went a little lighter today because we're still kind of sore. Like, I'm still sore. So, if you... There is more. But this is... Class ended like 15 minutes early, the last session. So there is a little bit more like we usually have with the pull-ups and stuff, but it's not too much more. It's not a total trick. So how are we feeling? Good? Anyone need any modifications or anything? No? Okay. All right. Just make sure there's no one waiting to hop on. Okay. All right, so if we are ready, I'm gonna put 20 minutes on the clock. Like I said, last session, people finished somewhere between 10 and 12 minutes in. When you finish, you are welcome to take breaks and run and walk outside, or you can do heavy farmer's carries. A couple people practice deadlifts for the combine. That's fine as well. Just make sure we keep moving. All right, here we go, 20 minutes on the clock. I'm gonna turn it up. All right, so we start with those power cleans. So bar right at shin level or right from the floor. And go, 6 power cleans. Good, yes. You wanna use the other one? Okay, good. Good. Good work on those burpees. Good job getting airtime on those jumps. Yep. And then as you finish your 5 burpees, we've got 4 sprints in here. If you're at home, you've got 2 minutes of hard cardio. Okay. And again, about 20 seconds hard on and 10 seconds of a little bit easier or almost a break. And then 20 seconds on again. You do that 4 times. Good. Solid work on those burpees. Nice airtime, Amy. Yes. Good.
Good.
Yeah. Solid power cleanse. Good job, guys. Yes. Go work, go work. Good job on those burpees. At home, if you're watching the replay, things to keep in mind with that power clean. Use those legs to help you get that bar or the dumbbells or the kettlebell up. So make sure you come all the way up. Let them help you. On that burpee, max jump, so as much air time as you can get. And then that cardio, you're working hard. If you have a my zone, you should be in the yellow or the red. More likely the red if you can. So trying to work on that cardio piece. Good. Good job getting all the way down to those power cleans, starting from low on the shins. Good. Good. Go work, go work. We keep moving. Go work. Keep moving. Good job being explosive, Annie. That's great. Yes. Good, Amy. Perfect form. Good. Solid burpees, Amy. So in here, we've got people who are just finishing up that five rounds. What I've been telling them, some people on the 5 a.m. went up to six rounds and you can keep going seven and eight, that's fine. Most have opted to go outside and run more sprints. Not as frequent sprints, so maybe sprinting down, walking back. Or a heavy farmer's carry. So if you finish early, by all means, keep moving for the 20 minutes though, okay? Because it's only 20, it's not 30 minutes. Good. So at this point, most people have finished all five rounds in here. So they are outside, they are sprinting, or they are doing a farmer's carry. If you are at home, you are playing the replay, by all means, keep moving. You've got this. Okay. If you finish early, keep moving. Hang on to that cardio for the next 4 minutes. Yeah. I know. That was awful. All right. I'm going to change the slide up here. So if you are in here and you can wipe down your weights, that would be great. You will not need your bar for anything else. So real quick, this next part, I will put the timer on for about 10 minutes. It won't even take you 10 minutes. So today's session is going to be a little shorter than it has been in the past. We have three rounds. Okay. We start over on the rig with negative pull-ups. So negative pull-up means that we pull up fast and we are slow on the way down, a count of five on the way down. Okay. If you need to use bands, that's fine. Starting here, pull up and then slow, counting to five all the way on the way down. Okay. If you want to use bands here, we've got some bands hanging, however you want to get that done, but it's a total of six negative pull-ups. Then when I talked to Silas yesterday about programming, his intention for the next two parts are weighted. You can either use a plate or you can use a dumbbell, but we have 12 leg lowers. So I would start with my shoulder blades off the ground, holding the weight up high, whether it's a dumbbell or a plate, and just bringing my legs down and then back up 12 times. And then the last part is a wall sit for 40 seconds. Okay. When you're leaning against the wall, I'm going to kind of use the rig for a sec. Okay. You can either hold, if you're using a plate, hold it out, or you can sit it on your legs. It's up to you, but make sure you sit all the way down in that full squat for 40 seconds. You run through all of that three times and that's it. People finish a different time. So I will say there's a stretch at the end, a frog stretch and a pigeon stretch. So if you have time, if you can get those done as well. But from here, you are free to get started. Like I said, I'll start the timer. Just real quick, if you're at home watching the replay, you don't have a pull-up bar because most people don't. You can do negative push-ups. So instead of just controlled push-ups and slowly rising, okay? Kind of the opposite motion because you're pushing away, but here you're kind of controlling on the way down. So make sure slowly rise, count to five, and then back down, slowly rise. Okay. But you should be able to do leg lowers with either a dumbbell or whatever you have at home. And then the wall sit again, 40 seconds. All right. Let me start that clock. Again, it's counting up. There we go. Good. Good. As you finish up, don't forget to stretch. Frog stretch is where we lie down, more to straddle, trying to get the inner thighs to stretch out. Butterfly stretch is where we sit on our bottom, soles together, and push our knees toward the ground. And that pigeon stretch, one leg goes in front, the other one straight behind, and then switch legs. And I would hold all of those for 30 seconds. All right, so again at home, as you're finishing up, we have a frog stretch, we got a butterfly, and make sure with that pigeon you do both sides. All right, I am at this point going to turn off the recording. Thank you for joining us this morning if you're watching. Hope you have a good rest of the day.